you can have an individual neuron that has 100,000 connections to 100,000 different cells. The signals that come into that cell are amazingly complex. If you ever hope to understand disease, ever hope to understand how drugs function, you need to understand how they function, where all those connections are intact.
When you see a traditional anatomy display like this, you just see how far science has come.
Today, we can even sequence single cells. This is a frontier that the pioneers of medicine couldn't even imagine.
That's why we're here in Philadelphia to meet Jim Eberwine, who is a pioneer in single cell sequencing. He'll show us how it's done.
What is the primary question you're now trying to address?
It revolves around understanding how different cells function within their natural microenvironment. Each cell is different from each other cell. If we can assess quantitatively these different biological features within these individual cells, that's one way of building up to the system and understanding it.
How does the method work?
Fortunately, here at Penn, we have a great collaboration with our neurosurgery department. We generally get human cortical samples for many of the neurosurgical specimens. But we also are able to get his hippocampal area. And it's in the hippocampus, which is the site of learning and memory in most mammalian systems. There are millions of cells within this area. And we go to individual cells that are connected to different neurons to see what the transcriptome or the genome looks like in those cells as a function of the different types of diseases. The key is being able to isolate the material from that individual cell. So for dispersed cells in culture, using the patch pipette like a needle is very useful. The problem with the primary cell culture is you remove the cells from all the neighboring cells, and those hundreds of thousands of different connections are lost. We developed a procedure called TIVA, which is transcriptome in vivo analysis, that allows us to isolate the RNA from any individual cell that's in its natural microenvironment. We can put our TIVA compound into the cell. It will go in through a chemical reaction. And then we focus light on a cell that's of interest to us. The chemical compound breaks apart. We can see that with a change in the color of the cell. And once we see that change, we know that chemical can then bind to the RNA in that individual cell. We can then take that entire tissue piece, grind it up, and the only RNA that we're going to isolate is RNA from the cell where this TIVA compound has been activated.
We identify the cell of interest, and then we activate TIVA only in this cell. We shine the laser now and then activate. And then after this activation, we can isolate this, and then we will have a full information of their transcriptomics. So even though in the same culture system, they show the different physiological response, but once we got the transcriptomics information, we can understand why they are different. Once we identify specific gene sets or specific genes, we can actually introduce those transcriptome itself instead of modifying the entire genome. We came up with phototransfections, which is using high intense laser light to making a transient pores into the cell. Once we introduce the small hole, you will see in the middle it will increase because these green dyes are getting into the cell. Immediately, transiently change from this cell type to this cell type. So based on this information and then analysis, we can actually explain what kind of information imaging results are showing. Now we have chance to define those based on the single cell study, combining with imaging technology and the RNA sequencing technology and bioinformatics. And they all three work together to identify the same goal.
the biological questions that are coming up is how many different cell types are there? Are those natural cell types? So what processes drive those cell types? And how do we define those cell types? There's more like a community or ecology of those cells interacting together to produce the system level, tissue level, organ level function. And so what we're really doing now is studying the ecology and systematics of the individual.
What inspires you about this work?
Each cell is different from every other cell, and it's the puzzle. You have all this data, you know there are answers within that data. The data itself is not knowledge. You have to sift through that data to try to gain that knowledge. It is our fondest hope, our greatest hope, that we'll be able to gain insight into these diseases from that data.
It's incredible to think that we can actually manipulate single neurons.
Even among seemingly identical cells, there is this functional diversity that may explain the operation of tissues and how they respond to disease.
But now we finally have the tools to unravel the collective behavior of cells.